Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. 10 people, including 2 children, have been shot in Manchester after a carnival event in the Moss Side area. Armed officers from Greater Manchester Police, GMP, were scrambled to Claremont Road at 2:30 a.m. on Sunday. Terrifying footage of the bloody aftermath shows a panicked group crying out and a voice asking, "Can you hear me?" Police and paramedics were seen surrounding the area as injured people, one just 12 years old, were taken to hospital in ambulances. One man remains in a serious but stable condition, police said, while updates on the injuries of 9 others were not given. Large crowds were drawn to the area earlier in the day for the Caribbean Carnival, which had finished some hours before the force added. Police are investigating the crime as attempted murder. Officers have now said they believe a shotgun was used. Scroll down for video. Forensics officers at the scene in Claremont Road, Moss Side, Manchester, where several people have been shot. Police are still lining the streets in Manchester where at least 8 adults and 2 children were shot. Police have taped off an area of shops where 10 people were gunned down in the early hours of Sunday morning. Pictures of the aftermath show people in the street after the shooting. 10 people are in hospital. The Moss Side Road can be seen littered with rubbish as officers cordon off a part of the street. The shooting took place in Claremont Road in the Moss Side area of Manchester this morning, around 2 miles from the city centre. The forensics teams and police officers stand around the party paraphernalia as they attempt to establish what happened in the early hours. Evidence of people inhaling nitrous oxide in balloons, known as hippie crack, at the event can be seen as empty canisters lie on the road. It is not clear how many times the gun was discharged, police said. Officers nearby rushed to the scene after people reported hearing loud bangs. Chief Superintendent Warsam Chowdhury said, "There were no arrests at the event itself. At 2:25 a.m. my officers got the report of a sound of 2 large bangs in the Claremont Road area. What they were faced with was a large crowd of several people continuing to celebrate the carnival. There was a state of panic. Officers carried out first aid. 10 people have received injuries which were related to gunshot. Probably a shotgun discharge. The injuries are serious for some but not life-threatening. This could have been far worse. These people need to be caught. I'd urge the community to pull together and work with the police. It's imperative that we catch these people and that we recover the firearm involved." Many people were shocked but others said Moss Side has experienced gun crime before. DJ Wayne Everett said the shooting happened at an illegal party and blamed the police for allowing it to go on, for the crime. He told Sky News, "The reason why this happened is the police, because the police allowed it to go on, it's that simple. The street party that went on here last night was illegal and every single year it goes on. In Moss Side we've had pubs shot up where gangs of man, 6, have stood outside the sports pub and shot up the sports pub. We've had open shootouts with gangs. This is on another level. Police are now scouring CCTV to try and find out exactly who attacked the revelers in the road. Those shot are being treated for pellet-type injuries. People at the carnival earlier in the day said it was a fun and peaceful event. The incident occurred hours after the event finished." Youth worker Kemoy Walker said he was shocked at the news, revealing there were multiple parties going on after the annual event ended. He said he had been on the main stage at the carnival on Saturday and had been at another street party on Claremont Road until about 11:30 p.m. He said, "The party I was at was beautiful. When I left there was lovely dancing. That's Moss Side, that's the culture. I'm in shock this morning." He said he believed the carnival would go ahead as planned on Sunday. "We need to get the message across to young people to make sure they are not getting involved in negativity," he said. "Moss Side has come such a long way and there are great things happening in our community now. Hearing this, I just think, why is this happening?" Detective Superintendent Debbie Dooley said, "We currently have a number of people in hospital all being treated for different injuries but thankfully most do not appear to be life-threatening at this time. Officers are trying to establish exactly where this incident took place and who is responsible for such a dangerous attack. Those living or visiting the area will understandably be concerned by this incident and we will have extra officers patrolling the area throughout the morning and into the coming days. people can be just about seen in the darkness in a video made in the aftermath of the Manchester shooting. An image of Claremont Road, at the junction with Rosebery Street, after the shooting, children were heavily involved in the annual carnival yesterday, but a shooting took place in the early hours. People living in the area said they were shocked and upset, while another person asked why somebody always got to get shot, as they posted images near the scene. One person said on Twitter, "Sad to wake up to news of 10 people being shot in Moss Side. The carnival was the best atmosphere and I didn't see a hint of trouble from 1 to 7 p.m. when I was there. People just there with friends and family dancing to great music. Families lined the streets in Moss Side to watch the carnival in Moss Side. But hours after the event, 10 revelers were shot." GMP said it had deployed a large number of armed and unarmed officers in the area after the alarm was raised. Investigations were taking place to identify exactly where the shooting occurred and who was involved. Anyone with any information was asked to call police on 0161 856 4166. Quoting incident number 297 of the 12th of August of the independent charity Crime Stoppers anonymously on 0800 555 111.